In the earlier lecture, we discussed about how Vault going to play a significant role within the HashiCorp stack, as well as what type of features it's going to provide. As a part of the demo, we will be having detailed discussion as well as demo on how Vault going to interact with these components, as well as a lot other components like cloud, plugins, data storage, and many more. Now, let us have some detailed understanding on the features provided by the Vault and what are all the roles it's going to play. When it comes to the features of the Vault, it provides secure secret storage facility. That's the primary goal of Vault, where it is going to provide the secret engine to generate the secrets, as well as it is going to encrypt the secret and store it in a secure way, so that no one without the proper permission, they will not be in a position to access the secrets. And it also facilitates option to dynamically generate the secrets. So once the purpose of the secret is done, that particular secret will be deleted, so that the lease period, once it gets over, the same credentials cannot be used by that specific application or the user. Vault also provides an option of data encryption as a service, where user doesn't need to worry about how to encrypt the data and where to store the encryption key and how to decrypt the data and how to access the decryption key and other algorithms, where Vault provides this as a service where user can provide the data to encrypt or decrypt and store the secrets within the Vault itself. So this encryption and decryption as a service will be used by lot other applications like database or to send the data over the wire. And every secret provided by the Vault will be having a lease period associated with it. So automatically the secret will get expired, and it provides facility to renew the lease or create a new secret and rotate the secrets. It also provides a facility to revoke the secret, so that in any case, if that particular access to the application or a specific user or a group of user or group of application, if that needs to be revoked, easily it can be revoked, or the security key or the secrets can be rotated. So basically, it is going to act as a centralized location or a system to maintain the secrets. In any development or in the DevOps operation, HashiCorp Vault will be playing the central role, where it is going to provide the features like identity validation. Any user or a machine or a service can authenticate by using various authentication methods, using certificates or private public key, or integrate with any other authentication systems or any centralized authentication system within an organization. Don't worry about the list. The list is really very huge. We are going to have lots of demo on each and every majorly used authentication methods, as well as the services and machines. And once the user is authenticated, we need to authorize, that is basically providing the permission whether the user or the system can have access to that specific resource or not. So it's going to have an associated policy what type of access the user can have, whether read or write, update, and a lot more, as far as I can associate time to that specific policy for how long the user or the machine can have that specific access. And while providing the secret key, the tokens needs to be generated. Sometimes I may need to generate the API keys. For that, there are lots of secret engines available. I can have my own secret engine built in within the HashiCorp Vault, or integrate any other third-party secret engines provided by n number of cloud providers or other private players. Once the secret is generated, it will be encrypted and stored within the Vault, and the user may need to use that particular secret to use the external resources. For that, the user needs to have access to that particular secret, and that needs to be decrypted and provided to the user. And Vault takes care of whether the user can have access to the secret or not, and how that needs to be decrypted, how long that needs to be provided. All such facility can be provided by the Vault. And we are going to have demo for each and every process that we discussed over here. Let me remind once again, don't worry about the terminologies used over here. We are going to have detailed discussion on each and every concept that we are discussing over here, right from authentication methods, secret engines, authorization policies, secret retrieval, how to do the identity validation, and lot more. To have a quick overview, these are all the authentication methods and the secret engine supported by HashiCorp Vault. For example, within authentication methods, it supports almost most of the cloud providers, private players like GitHub, and integration with the popular Java authentication methods or PKI certificates. And I can have my own custom authentication method as well. When it comes to secret engine, it can have secret engines right from the basic secret engine like key value pair or integrate with other databases and built-in stack of HashiCorp or other cloud providers, and I can have my own custom secret engine as well. This is just to have a brief overview on what are all the different authentication methods and the secret engines that we are going to have as a part of our discussion. Along with that, we will be having detailed discussion about various concepts like development servers, seal, unseal, lease, renew, revoke, authentication, tokens, response wrapping, policies, telemetry, key rotations, plugins, sentinel, password policies, high availability, integrated storage, PGP, GPG, and keybase, recovery mode, resources, secret engines, authentication methods, audit devices, vault agents, and quotas. This is not the only concept that we are going to discuss, a lot more, and let's get started with the demo by installing Vault as a part of the local system first and get into the detailed discussion and move on to the production grade deployment.